Welcome to Hybris News. My name is Suresh Kocharlu. The Income Tax Department on Thursday extended the IT exemption available under the LTC cash voucher scheme to employees of state governments, state-owned enterprises and private sector. The Central Board of Direct Taxes in a statement said that the payment of cash allowance subject to a maximum of 36,000 rupees per person as deemed leave travel concession fare per person for a round trip to non-central government employees shall be allowed income tax exemption subject to fulfillment of certain conditions. In order to provide the benefits to other employees of non-central government employees, that is, it has been decided to provide similar income tax exemption for payment of cash equivalent of LTC fare to the non-central government employees also, the CBDT said. Non-central government employees include employees of the state governments, public sector enterprises, banks and private sector. The conditions listed down by the Central Board of Direct Taxes for availing the tax exemption under the LTC cash voucher scheme require the employee to spend a sum equal to 3 times of the value of the deemed LTC fare on purchase of goods or services which carry a GST rate of 12% or more from GST registered vendors or service provider through digital mode between October the 12th, 2020 and March the 31st, 2021. And obtains a voucher indicating the GST number and the amount of GST paid. The employees have an exercise, an option for the deemed LTC fare in lieu of the applicable LTC in the block year of 2018-21. Also, an employee who spends less than 3 times of the deemed LTC fare under the cash voucher scheme shall not be entitled to receive the full amount of the deemed LTC fare, and the related income tax exemption and the amount of both shall be reduced proportionately. With a view to compensate central government employees and incentivize consumption, thereby giving a boost to the consumption expenditure, the union government had on October the 12th allowed payment of cash allowance equivalent to LTC fare to central government employees subject to certain fulfillment conditions. It has also been provided since the cash allowance of LTC fare is in lieu of the deemed actual travel, the same shall be eligible for income tax exemption on the lines of the existing income tax exemption available for the LTC fare. In view of the COVID-19 pandemic and the resultant nationwide lockdown, as well as the disruption of transport and hospitality sector, as also the need for observing social distancing, the number of employees are not able to avail of the LTC in the current block of 2018-21. The Central Board of Direct Taxes said that since the exemption is in lieu of the exemption provided by the LTC fare, an employee who has exercised an option to pay the income tax under the concessional tax regime shall not be entitled for this exemption. The legislative amendment to the provisions of the Income Tax Act 1961 for the purpose shall be proposed in due course, it added. Explaining further, the Central Board of Direct Taxes said if the deemed LTC fare is 80,000, that is 20,000 into 4 people, then the amount to be spent under the scheme is 2,40,000. Thus, if an employee spends 2,40,000 or above on specified expenditure, he shall be or she shall be entitled to a full deemed LTC fare and the related income tax exemption. However, if the employee spends say only 1,80,000, then he or she shall be entitled to 75%, that is 60,000 of the deemed LTC fare and the related income tax exemption. In case the employee already received 80,000 from the employer in advance, he has to refund 20,000 to the employer as he could spend only 75% of the required amount. Nangyan Company LLP partner Shailesh Kumar said that the effective income tax benefit for employees may range between 6 to 9% of the total amount of expenditure incurred, depending on the highest slab of the tax applicable to the employee. Thus, this income tax benefit may actually be considered as a discount on expenditure, which employee has already planned to incur instead of a reason to incur expenditure. On the other hand, income tax foregone by the government may be offset by additional GST revenue on expenditure incurred by the employees, Mr. Kumar added. Thank you for watching.